Hello guys, Fruxus is here, and today I have another update of the development of NeosVR. I don't actually have that many features this week, partly because I have devoted some of my time to finishing a side project that we did, where we essentially transferred a portion of the Czech National Science Fair into VR, and you can see more of that in the video here. And I have also finished the submission of my older demo, Neos the Universe, to the Oculus Store for Gear VR, and it will also soon be coming for Vive on Steam. But another reason is that the new feature is a really big one. Neos now essentially supports parallel worlds. And what it is that you can actually run multiple worlds in parallel at the same time, and it doesn't matter whether you are hosting the worlds or if you are just connected to someone else's session. You can have multiple sessions running on your own computer with people joined in or just for yourself and just switch between them like tabs in a browser, or you can be joined to multiple worlds or even combination of these. And the switching is completely effortless, it's instant because you are still running these worlds and you are still connected to all the sessions. It's not implemented in some cheap way where you just disconnect from one world and connect to another, and when you switch you just do it again. You are running these worlds completely in parallel, and they are actually running and transferring data. And this is a very powerful feature, because for example you can be in multiple sessions where different things are happening and you can just quickly switch between them based on what's happening in the world right now. Or when you are, for example, constructing a world with multiple friends and you want to construct something in clean slate without all the clutter around, you can just create a blank new world, switch over to it, construct your object, finish it, just put it in a bubble, switch to the other world, grab it from the bubble, put it into the shared world and continue working. And even Neos itself uses this functionality for implementing something I call user space. User space is essentially just another world in the system, although it has certain privileges. And essentially it constantly runs as overlay of all the other worlds and provides them with certain functionality. Like you can bring up a menu and switch between the worlds, close them, or create a new ones. But I think it might be best to just show you how it works. So let's jump into VR and let's have a look.
So hello and welcome to Neos again. So as you can see, we no longer start in the testing place called Scratch Space, but instead in this simple grayish world. And that is because Neos now supports running multiple worlds in parallel and also starting other worlds from some other worlds. So instead, we start in the simple gray world, which essentially has just these two options right now, and it allows me to start a new server, and I can initialize it in two different ways. And essentially, my colleague Karel is waiting downstairs, so I'm not going to keep him waiting. I'm going to start a server, and he's actually going to see the new server in the menu, and he's going to join in. So now you can see it loaded or initialized essentially the simple Scratch Space again. Karel should join soon. And there he is. Hello.
Hello, Fruxus. How are you?
Hello. So we are back to the old Scratch Space where we can do stuff. We can test out various features of Neos and test out if the underlying engine works correctly. Let's say I'm going to bounce the particles. Or we can make the floor to be made from bricks. Yeah, and Karel is already building something. But what's super cool is that when we are in this world, I can actually switch back. Actually, I'm going to keep this one. I can actually switch back to the simple hub. And Karel, can you keep building something like build a house or something like that?
Yeah.
I can actually. This menu, this is actually part of another world, which is called user space, and it's essentially like an overlay up of all the worlds, and only I can see my own user space worlds. Like Karel, if I show him this, he cannot see this menu, but he has his own, so you can use it to interact with Neos. So you can see I also when I travel, the menu travels with me. Essentially, technically, it's just another world, which is just sending commands to the engine to do stuff, and it displays whatever it needs above all the worlds. And I can use it to switch back to the simple home. And here I again have the menu to start a server, and I can actually start another server right now. So this is completely new, fresh Scratch Space, but I can actually switch back to the Scratch Space where Karo was, and I can see he's continue building the house. And in the meanwhile, I can actually switch back. Karel can keep building in the other world I'm hosting. And let's say I import something here. So I take the importer. Import the Solirax Rutenberg office. Or yeah, the Rutenberg Ventures office. So we have, yeah, here it is. This is a very nice scan. And I'm going to invite Karel into this world again also. So it's importing. Now let's rescale it, so it's nice and big. There we go. And let's invite Karel. Oh, you are already gluing the house together. So, Karel, can actually join the other world. I started a new world called Fruxinator 2 World 1, and I imported something there. So I'm going to wait over there. So Karel should be joining this world as well. And he doesn't actually have to exit the first world. Oh, here you are. Hello.
Hello.
Oh, it's probably loading for him.
We are in. Nice. Front Adventures offices.
Yeah. Well, it was still a river at this point.
Or like river offices. Yeah. Nice.
Yeah. We have the cubes here. And nice. This is just for testing. And the funny thing is that the other world is still running. So when I switch here, I can actually see Karel frozen right now because he doesn't send any new data. I can steal material and give him a different one. And essentially, he's now interacting with the other world. Later on, it will actually be the avatar will show that the person is in another world. I'm not sure what the term will be for that, but that's going to be figured out soon. So Karel is building a car here. I can see.
Yeah.
Actually, can you instead of building something here, can you go back to the original world and build something there?
Ooh. Yeah,
I'll
sure.
Continue building the house.
You're kicking me out.
Yeah, I'm not kicking you out.
Nice.
I'm not kicking you out. I'm just telling you to move to the other world. You're going to join the other world soon.
Yep.
So you can see that his avatar right now is actually frozen, but he's technically still here. He's just not sending any new data. And what I can do is actually I can modify his avatar. I'm going to draw a simple hair on him. I'm going to grab the glue. Where's the glue? There is the glue. I'm going to glue the hair. So while he's busy in building the house in the other world, I'm going to make a surprise for him. There we go. I'm going to change his controller. And what else? I can actually extract material from his headset and apply it to the 3D scan so it will glow when he will talk like this. Oh, that is enough. And another cool thing about this is that I can actually the tools that I have equipped and the state of my avatar and things like that, I can actually draw like glue something to my own controller. So when I take the glue, let's make a spiral. Let's take the glue. I'm going to glue the spiral to my controller. Oops, I pressed the wrong button. Like this. So it's now my part of my controller. I can also change the material. Let's say I want nice metallic controllers. And when I switch, this is actually just part of the world itself. So when I switch to the other world, they are going to look as they looked before. And you can see Karel is still building the house. Although it looks glued, it's glued weirdly. Oh, I think you glued it.
To my hand.
Yeah. It glued to his controller. Yeah. Can you actually leave this world and join again? That will destroy that part and it will make you a fresh avatar.
It's a good idea.
Yeah. Oh, I don't think he left. He just. What is he doing? Hey, you didn't leave. You just joined again.
I'm back.
Yeah, but there is one you still. You're here twice.
There's
now.
Two of me right now.
There's two of you. I can actually. This is another funny thing. This will be actually forbidden or disallowed by default in the AI, and you don't have the glue anymore. But this is cool. Can you actually switch to this other avatar? Because Karel right now is actually running. He has two instances of this world. He's connected to both of them, and they both act like they are independent. And this is something that is just possible with the engine. But Karel, can you actually join? Can you actually use the menu to switch to the other instance of this world, the one that is not active right now?
So yeah, I think so.
And you have this avatar. Yeah. And can you actually just leave
this
instance? Can you press the X button to leave this avatar?
Sure.
And there we go. And now he can switch back to this one.
And now I'm here.
Yeah.
I'm back.
So this super cool about the system is that you can actually be in multiple worlds at once. I can even start a completely new one. I can show you the empty one. This is all white. Just you can just draw and that is all. I use this mostly to testing and debugging some systems to get rid of the influence of all the stuff happening in the scratch space. So let's actually invite Karel into this war so he can notice that I drew hair on him. So you are still building here. Karel, can you actually switch back to the world to the world one? So let's wait for him to switch. Ah, there we go.
Yeah. I'm back.
Yeah, and you have hair. Yes. And everything glows when you talk.
What? Yeah.
And you can see that I kept all my tools. I have the metallic controller again. Actually, I'm going to... Wasn't a good idea to make it dark. And you can see I have the metallic controller. The state stays with the world itself. And by the way, Carl actually started it another world. Can you join Fruxinator world 2?
Yeah.
So I'm going to wait for him over here. This is a very empty one. But it's actually quite interesting because all you have is... Oh, hello! And we are... Welcome hello. To the void!
We are in heaven, or...?
No, just void. It is empty. All you can do is draw. But it's actually funny because even we cannot move anywhere because there is nothing to move to. But we can move on our drawings. So when we draw something like this, I can actually teleport on the drawing. And we can actually, like, from nothing, we can construct a very simple world. And, like, oh, you are moving my... I can actually build, like, a net of things, of drawings. Make them huge.
Again. Make the drawings huge again.
Let's not. And and construct a world just from simple drawings.
Okay.
It's very, it feels very strange, like some kind of eerie world. It's actually, I don't like this world anymore. I'm going to okay. End it. So, and actually, if you watch Corel, it will throw him back into the simple home. So let's meet back in one of the two wars.
Okay.
So I ended the war, and Karel should probably switch back to one of them. He's not here. Oh, you are here. Hello. Can we actually go to the first one?
Yeah, sure.
The war zero.
You're everywhere, man.
Yeah. Super cool. And ooh, you're making the house huge.
I'm making House of Neos.
Yeah. House of Neos.
A cathedral. And awesomeness.
I'm actually going to go back to the world and do some other modification to his avatar. Give him another surprise. Papa. Where do I have? Yeah, here it is. So I'm going to import something. Let's say I import my plush tiger. What is NeosVR World Discovery Dependencies Testing Assets? Here we go. Tiger plush. There we go. It's going to load. And I'm actually going to glue this to his avatar, like this. There we go. And we'll actually move it in. So, Karel, I made some other modification in the other wars. Can we actually
go?
Can we actually switch over there?
Go there.
See.
Yeah.
And we have a tiger.
I have tiger grills to my head. Nice.
Yeah.
It's very kind of you.
Yeah. I'm going to spare you, and I'm going to end this session as well. So let's meet back in the first world.
Yeah.
Ah, there we go.
Okay, so, back in the cathedral?
Yep.
Nice.
And now I'm going to ask you something different. Can you actually start a war yourself?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm actually going to join Karel's war. So you can see, I'm still hosting this war. But where is the menu? I'm going to wait for it to pop up. Ah, there it is. So now I can join Karel's war. And there I am. And now Karel is actually the host, and I'm the guest in this world. And I can make some modifications here.
This is Carol's world.
Yeah, this is Carol's world. He's hosting this one. Yeah. But the funny thing is that we are now both hosting one world, and we are joined or what's the word? We are connected to each other's world. So I can still go back to mine, and everything is here. I can switch back. Oh, you're making it very very dark. Actually, going to do something fun. I actually got an idea. No. I need to grab a material. Let's grab some material that glows, like this one. And let's make these cubes glow. And let's make them huge. And they are flying. And we can see them flying around us.
In the distance. I'm going there.
And to make a little bit of light.
I'm chasing them.
Are you chasing them? Yeah, I can see it.
I'm here.
We're making lights.
Yeah.
So you can see. We also essentially everything. Everything is part of the world itself. Like there is nothing except of the simple menu which is running in the overlay. Everything is part of the world, including the avatars. So when we switch between the worlds, we keep our positions. We keep everything. I can just switch between them like that, or I can even start completely new one again. So I have multiple worlds running. I'm now hosting two worlds.
Lasers.
And Kakarot is still chasing. Oh, hello.
I was.
Can you actually? Because it's only fair, can you actually? I'm going to go to the other world and I'm going to do something there. Can you actually modify my avatar somehow to surprise me?
Okay.
So I'm going to switch. So now I have no idea what Carol is doing to my avatar. Before you do, but when you are done, can you come to the other world and tell me that I can join or switch?
Okay.
So I have no idea what Carol is doing, but I can keep constructing his house. So let's glue it together. Oh, there are some particles. Oops, I hit something physical. You can get lost very easily. Oh, there is some glue here. Do I have glue? I think Carol took all the glue. Yeah, I don't have glue, so I...
Yeah.
Oh, is it ready?
I think it's ready for clues.
Oh, I didn't even make any modifications here. I was looking for glue and I think you ate all the glue. Oh, there is glue, actually. Yeah, we need two panels. I just wanted to glue the house together. There we go. I'm going to do it before I leave. So, I'm going to back to the other house. I have a face. I have a face in my face.
And I can switch your eyes on and off.
Can I switch my own eyes? Ah, I can switch my... I don't... What is it? There's another light here. Oh, there we go. Yeah, I can switch my eyes. I can switch my own eyes on.
Yeah. I need to stop my
eyes to switch them on and off. I'm not sure this is a good user design. Yeah, you need to use a point. You need to use sharp pointy things to switch your eyes on.
It's like in real life, but only you can switch it off only. In real life.
This is actually funny, like in if I make it completely dark and I go somewhere where we cannot see anything. I can actually go on now. So like now I can actually go and I say, I cannot see anything. Actually, wait a second. I'm going to stop my eyes so I can see. And now I can see.
Nice.
This is what I was saying. VR allows you to defy the laws of physics, or even laws of common sense. Like, stop your eyes to see.
And biology.
I don't like this avatar. I'm going to do the other thing, and I'm going to, because I want to see how I look with this. I'm going to move somewhere to the center. I'm actually going to switch back to my simple home, and I'm going to join Carol's server again. So I'm here twice now.
And
actually, I can see. I can actually see my avatar, and I can switch my eyes.
Yeah, it's maybe more funny from the outside.
Yeah, this is me. And I can actually switch between the instances. So I'm here. I actually can hear myself for a second. Sorry. Yeah, because the system just considers this another avatar. It doesn't care. This is actually mine. Like on this computer, it's completely independent. And like, there are some huge boxes now. So I'm going to actually I'm going to leave one of the instances. I'm going to leave this one. I don't.
Funny one.
No more fun instance. This is pretty much it. You can do all kinds of silly stuff. And what's the important takeaway is that you can by yourself, you can host multiple wards and you can work on them in parallel. People can join each of the wards that you are hosting and working them independently. And you can also be in multiple hosted wards at the same time, and you can just switch between them like tabs in a browser. So it's as simple as that, but very powerful. So this one is pretty empty. This one is this is with the house, and Carol, can actually exit this one? Or no? Actually, I'm going to show you one last thing. This one is more work in progress. Carol, can you join me in the Fruxinator World Zero? There we go.
Here?
So I'm not sure if this is going to work right actually, but what is not completely finished. But here, this is sort of like a copy slot, which allows me to transfer objects between multiple worlds. So let's say I like this house that Karel built, so I can grab it, make it smaller, and I hope this works. I'm going to put it in the box. And now it's copied. Can we go to your board? To the board.
Okay.
And I can see when I switch between the boards, I actually keep the object there. So we are here, and I can actually now grab it and put it here. And do you see?
Nice.
And it's here.
That's awesome.
So I actually just moved objects from one board to another, like transcendent. Oh, I have no idea. like a shared clipboard between the worlds. So this is just a simple demonstration of a concept that actually shows you that you can also bridge multiple worlds. So it's not just that you can be in multiple parallel worlds at once, but you can move stuff back and forth between them. So for example, when I want to build something simple. I want to build something without having a lot of clutter. So I let's say I create this empty board and I draw something nice here, and everything is calm. And I draw this, and I put it in my clipboard. And I go back to you were drawing glasses, but you weren't fast enough. Actually, I drew something in another server I started. I can now pull it out. And Karel, can you log here? You can't actually see it yet because it's not pasted. Can you log here at my controller?
Yeah. Pop. Nice. Spring or like?
I drew this in another world, and I'm actually going to try some. I destroyed your glasses. So this is object from another world. It's from another universe, and now it's in yours.
I wasn't. Nice.
So it's. It seems to be working very well. Auto, I'm sure I can actually let's try break it. Let's try breaking it. So I'm going to import something here in Carol's Wars. I'm going to import the tiger again because I like the tiger. So Rex testing assets. Let's import it here. So I have the tiger. Actually, Carol, can you look here? I'm going to put it in my clipboard, and you will actually see it disappear.
Okay. It's gone.
It's now in my clipboard.
You're a magician.
Essentially, right now the object is in the user space world, which is running above all the worlds, and it then just copies it to another world that is currently focused. So can we go back to the world zero? There we go. And I'm going to pull it out here. And there
from
it is.
Your head.
Do you see it?
Nice. Yeah, I see the tiger.
Nice. What's super cool about this is that the system also made sure that all the assets necessary to represent were transferred into this world as well.
Oh.
You can hug the tiger. So you can see, you can build something or import something in one world, and you can actually just grab it and move it to another, and to sort of a way that bridges the world. Let's try something more. I actually have. I'm thinking what you can do. Let's try it with music. So let's import music here. I'm going to import something nice. Lyrics testing assets. It's not properly tested, and there were still some bugs yesterday. So, where is the music? But I'm actually glad it's working a lot better than I expected. Oh, let's try this one. So, do you see music here?
Yep, I see the bar. Nice.
So it's playing. I'm going to put it in my clipboard.
Your favorite.
It's in the clipboard, and can we go back to your vault, because this is very cool, because I'm actually transferring something from a world that I am hosting to a world that Karel is hosting. So we are here, and I'm going to try to pull it here from the clipboard.
Okay.
Bop.
Ah, I see it.
Ah.
Nice, and it's playing.
It's playing.
Yeah, it's playing.
So it works.
This is party house now.
We failed at making it fail. So, honestly, I actually thought it would break or crash the system, but it seems.
Should I try my bubble too?
Yeah, maybe we can try yours. Actually, can we try it with something? Oh, and I think it broke. Yeah. Maybe wait a few seconds. I think we broke it. Yeah, so there are still definitely bugs. Oh, that is normal. Like this is still very, very early stage for this project. So bugs are to be expected. And we can see Karel's world is gone. Yeah. So just mine remain. So I'm going to actually wait if he's going to join one of these worlds.
Huh?
You are back. So you crashed it.
I found you. Yeah, I succeeded.
Yeah, so we succeeded at making it fail.
Yeah.
That is actually good, because I can look at the log and I can see why it crashed, and I can fix it. So it's always good when we can reproduce some bugs. And also, last thing I wanted to show you is I can actually like make particle system. Shoot like this. Oh, this is not very good, but. Let's make it wiggle. And now I can actually switch. Can you actually do something more with the particles in this world? Can you like create some kind of creation
something.
To go to the other world? Because this is a very funny aspect, because normally, like in NEOS, when there are two people, you can sort of keep track of what's going on. But when there's even more people, you can. It's a lot harder to keep track when everyone is doing something else. But when we started like switching between the worlds, I'm sure I'm going to exit this one. When we started switching between the worlds, it's a really strange feeling, because you switch from one world to another, and then you switch back, and suddenly the world you switch back to is different, like some kind of time jump, because other people were still active in that world and they made some modifications to it, and that's. It's hard to describe. Like everything with VR is very, very. You have to experience it. So I think Karel should have something sensible right now. Let me just do something silly here. I'm just going to make simple light and let's make the ground go crazy like this. Yeah, this doesn't actually work. Yeah, like this. Yeah, I think that is it. Let's go back and see what's Karel up to. Ooh! You are showering the tiger in rainbows.
Yeah. I'm making...
Tiger shower.
Tiger fountain.
I don't think fountains work like this.
Yeah. They have usually naked people in them.
Yeah, like, and the water or whatever is pouring out of them, not on top of them.
Yeah. <That's>, yeah.
Yeah. It's will like, it will be more like luxury. Like, can we try it? Yeah, can you put it in the tiger? Let me grab one of them. Does it work? Oh, it works. Yeah, let's actually put him a little bit higher.
Yep.
And like this. Oops, actually I'm not good with this hand. Oh, it's just pouring. I didn't put it there properly.
Too little pressure.
We need more rainbow pressure.
Uh-huh. This is nice.
There we go.
This is nice.
Yeah, tiger fountain.
Yeah.
So he's pouring rainbows. Let's make it dark here.
Let's make it dark here.
He's crying.
He's crying rainbows.
He's crying rainbows.
Yeah.
You're messing his mouthpiece.
He's crying now.
So I'm going to exit this war again. Oh, poor tiger. He's crying rainbows.
Oh, don't cry.
Don't cry.
We can drink it. It will make you live forever. The tears of the tiger.
Tears of the tiger. Can we make multiple tigers? So he's not crying. So he has some friends.
Okay.
Let's. I'm going to grab the tiger. Grab one. So I'm going to start duplicating him like this. I like duplicating the tigers. For some reason it's a really interesting feeling to be able to duplicate some objects. Sort of like you are pulling matter out of thin air.
A lot of tigers.
Yeah, I'm going to make an entire sphere of tigers around us.
And it's still absolutely smooth?
Yeah. They're not very heavy models. I just admit. There we go.
Tribes.
You are completely surrounded by tigers. And you are still shooting rainbows.
Let's shoot our way outside.
I'm not sure it works either.
It doesn't work.
Tigers everywhere. And I can start another ward. Actually, can you stay in this ward? I'm going to make another surprise for you in new world. But I don't see the menu anymore. I think it's somewhere. I'm going to teleport. Oh, there it is. So I'm actually going to move this to the side. I'm going to import Karel. Papa, testing assets. There's Karel somewhere here. Ah, there we go. So he's importing. Ah, there we go. Let's just check on him. You are still doing stuff?
You are still doing stuff.
Good. Let's make him wiggle. Using the wiggler tool. And now we can make copies. Also, these are actually quite heavy. I think they are about 250,000 vertices. So this is not running so well, but it works. So I actually started another world. Can you join that as well?
Yeah, going
it's
right
world
there.
World 5. But it looks funny.
Okay. That's a lot of me's.
Yeah, lots of Karels.
Doing...
And we are doing some kind of space ballet, or I'm not sure what it is.
Space, or like swimming weirdly.
But it's juddering, so let's. It might be running more smoothly for you because. But I'm running on a laptop, so. Let's delete these. So I think that is mostly everything. So you can see NeosVR now supports parallel walls. Even mostly you can transfer stuff between walls. It doesn't matter whether you host or whether you are hosting the world or if you are just a guest. It just works. in most cases. And when it doesn't, we are going to fix it, and it's going to work. Yeah. It looks like awesome.
It's supposed to be awesome. I'm very bad writing.
I fixed it. And we can glue it together.
To make it huge.
Or small. Or huge.
Or very small.
Huge.
We can actually let's move it to the other world. To the one with tigers. So okay. I copied it. And it's here.
And are inside the sphere?
Oh, let's go inside the sphere. Yeah, that's a good idea.
Okay.
Are you inside the sphere? You made a hole! There's a hole.
I'm preparing to enter. I made a hole here. So I can enter. Nice.
So there it is. You can see Neos. It's awesome.
Nice.
That's a tech. Yeah. And we can duplicate it. Neos is awesome.
It's true.
And it's everywhere.
And it's everywhere.
And if you don't
it's
agree,
be everywhere, so.
Then the tigers are going to convince you
watching
otherwise.
I think they agree.
Oh,
like,
you are making a Bezier curve.
Through that.
Yeah. So there we go, accidental Bezier curve. And I'm going to help Carol make it nice and smooth. So we are in a giant sphere of tigers, with the Neos is also everywhere, and we are just randomly building a Bezier curve for whatever reason.
This is crazy.
We are collaborating on it, so you can see the collaboration everywhere. Oh, I can make it. Oh, this might be interesting for studying mathematics, like studying loops and things like that.
And tigers.
Yeah, so I think this is mostly all for today. Like most of like all the important stuff was shown, and we are now mostly goofing off. So I'm going to end this war, and see you next week, or more or less.
See you later.
Yeah. See ya. But there we go. I'm back in the home, and it's the end.